My name is Kate Crehan, and this is my daughter, Layla, and she has been diagnosed with autistic disorder. Layla has a brother who is 14. They both have been diagnosed with the autistic disorder. However, Indiana is nonverbal, and he has different hurdles than Layla has. They both have diagnoses that go with their autism. Layla has anxiety and ADHD. Indiana has apraxia and dyspraxia. I mean, it's a different world for both of them. When I first found out that there was a possibility of autism with Layla, I didn't really have a reaction. It was more, I went straight into research mode. I got overwhelmed at that point. I got very nervous. And the first thing I thought was, are my kids gonna have any friends? That was a concern. But after that, we just went forward. You know, I looked at them and I thought, man, they're perfect. And they're gonna have tons of friends, and they do. I mean, they have amazing lives. Layla didn't speak until she was 5. So it's very hard trying to figure out what it is to get your kids involved with when they can't tell you what they like and what they don't like. Luckily, Layla started speaking at 5, so we started getting somewhere. But until then, I just started throwing my kids through whatever door opened to see what would stick. We started looking for swim lessons, and they were denied by everyone. They didn't want to be dealt with because they had behavioral issues until we found Baby Otter, and they taught them both how to swim in 5 days. They had a special needs swim team. So we put them on the swim team, and that's when we really saw that Layla was actually an excellent swimmer. And then we found the Special Olympics. And when she was 10 years old, that's when she started on the swim team. And that's when we saw a completely different child.
My biggest achievement is winning all 5 races in a pentathlon in Atlanta at swimming. It was one of my biggest moments in my life. I love both paddleboarding and swimming because they help me feel strong and there. And it helps me deal with my anxiety. And I love to be in the water always.
Layla got chosen to start on the paddling team for Special Olympics, and honestly, I didn't think it was going to go very well. But when she got on that paddle and she fell off, you just saw this, like this silverback in her come out, and she was like, this is not going to beat me. And she started just mad paddling and aggressive paddling, and I just saw a different person.
I love being in the water, I love being in the ocean, and seeing amazing, amazing animals. Like all kinds of animals, like manatee, dolphin, birds, random fish. That's just jumping out of the water.
Right now, Layla is training for the crossing for cystic fibrosis. She has a friend with cystic fibrosis, and she wants to prove to Hannah how much she loves her by paddling 80 miles from Bimini to Lake Worth in June. So she has taken on some pretty intense training.
I'm learning about sports nutrition, and I'm paddling in longer hours and longer distances, trying to step it up.
It's very important for people with autism to have a track. Having that to focus on helps keep their world feeling safe. And the paddling has given that to her. She paddles probably 4 days a week, at least. She's also doing outrigger canoeing with a team to keep her strong, and that also keeps her in the community and with those people that look out for her. And they're constantly being role models for her. And so it has helped her want to also be a role model. Layla has a little lack of confidence there. She doesn't know if she's a role model, but she does set out to be.
Yep, and I hope to inspire other people to set goals for yourself and never give up and do the things you love.